Salut comrades and welcome back to Let's Play. I almost said Master of Orion. No, to Endless Space. My name is Vadim. We're moving forward. Oh, this is very good. Star system to colonize. So let's see what next should we do. First of all, we should take the most delicious star systems in the center, but the most important thing we need to do is to lock oh my god, look at this amoeba grew so fast. To lock AIs inside their starting points, so the most dangerous one right now is the United Empire, so we should, and they are most annoying one usually, so we first of all should capture this star system, and it's good as I see. And the second one, we should make contact with the United Empire as fast as we can. And compare these guys who almost didn't develop, and these guys, and these guys. Yeah, they will give us much trouble in the future. Okay, we received two bonuses. That will give us a huge increase in production. Okay, this one should start using building colony ships too. So let's check, is everything okay? And yeah, let's go further. As you see, the bonus that we've just received give us huge production bonus, and now okay, wait. And now the ships build like crazy. Okay, we can take one of these two planets, two systems. To annoy pilgrims even further. But they are not that good, so I don't think we should do that. Yeah, we should concentrate on capturing the center of the galaxy. Plus 75. Yeah, new colony ships, of course. That's what I need the most at the moment, at least. So bad news, United Empire, not that friendly. Pilgrims, yes, That's what I'm talking about. Okay, let's see, what should we do next? Can go here. Ah, okay, next we should go for research. Then maybe for... No, first for research. Now look how many ships are being created. Still need to go on with them, cause there is a loads of star systems that we should colonize. And this one I will build food improvement here. More colony ships, because they are never enough. And even more. Okay, that would be this system have two premium class planets, one second class, and this is very good. Okay, I think I should go here, yeah, as quick as possible. And yeah. Everyone should go build the colonies. Actually, this random events they helped me a lot. Sometimes it happens, sometimes it don't. You shouldn't rely on it, but if I wouldn't have this event, it wouldn't be that bad. Okay, this one. Okay. That would mean that my colonization rate would drop just a little bit. So you see, we've produced that much of colony ships that my population ended. See, on my home world. That's kind of funny. Okay, we've reached another race. Hope they will be become our friends, not our enemies. Another good colonization. Planet, at least. Okay, now I need to reach these guys. Okay, so far so good. Let's see what. Oh my god. Okay, this is some random event, actually quite disastrous. The question is, do we need science now? So the options are those: we can sacrifice our science for 10 thirds on 75%. This one is non-negotiable because it will have the morale decrease will be drastic. And hostile, I will lose my population, and I do not want to lose my population. Okay, I will sacrifice science, I guess, for a while. Because my population is not that great at the moment. And in the meantime, I will build. Build the minor things that would help my development. Okay, another good planet, it's perfect. Let's see, what else do we have? Is this good one? Not that much. What else? Yeah, this looks decent, at least. It has mushrooms. It's one of the most, one of the best. I think I should colonize this one before my opponent does. Oh no, he will stuck here for a long time. So shrooms, they increase your morale at the planets, and morale is the thing that can screw your game or can help you a lot based on your choices during the game. And because I have so many ships, I have financial problems. Am I Actually, the most worries that I have about game right now is this two these two races. Because they can ruin my blockade. And I hope that won't happen. Let's see for delicious planets that you can colonize. Yes, I think that the best ones are already taken by me, of course. Yeah, it seems so. So let's take the other ones. Since the most troubles I expect are coming from this direction, I will send my ships there. In the first place. Yeah, huge money problems. Know what, I will... No, I cannot. Okay, that would help us survive a turn. You see, they have colony ship that would ruin me if it will. Yeah, I've chased it away. Now I can colonize this planet. Actually, I accidentally colonized not the planet that I wanted. But I will compensate it by making research. Or no, I will do it later. Right now we have bigger problems. Yeah, so we start colonizing everything that we see. And later on this will... It might at least shoot us in the back, cause... as you see... there is a thing about numbers of colonies. It's of course it's a kind of balanced thing. You see the because more colonies you have, less happy is your population will be, and it's I don't know the mechanic of that because I don't see any reasons why it should be so. Because okay, my you see my approval already is quite low. I think I will go for this one. Cause usually the more the better, but in their case... Okay, I have a... big problem with money, so yeah, that should do it. Actually, the amount of colonies that we've produced might shoot us in the back, because our population will be not very happy. It will not produce anything, and usually you do not have that many of colonies that early, as it is in my case. But we will see. So just basic development for now on. Can decrease taxes. Okay, well, and moving on with colony ships, I think. Okay, let's see if we can offer peace to someone. The good thing is this system is taken so far, because they will not go for my system before they will take this one. Okay, United Empire. Okay, new exploration ship. Not very good. Friendly locals. Good. Because the exploration ships, why do I need it? I already explored a whole bunch of territory. Okay, I might take this. So, I don't need you anymore. And I have metal factions, so shouldn't be any problem for a while. And the most important thing is not to allow them to trade between themselves, trade technologies, so you will have a big advantage over them. So I finally researched this technology. It's kind of auto lab in Master of Orion. It will give you research points no matter what, no matter how many people you have. You just build it and it starts giving you a point. Next thing I'm worried about is my happiness level, so I will go for infinite supermarkets. Yeah, I don't know what is it. With the vastly improved methods for selecting, growing and harvesting foods, it is possible to deliver any known dish or ingredient anywhere within a colonized world. Local markets have essentially become infinitely large. Okay, good for them. Amoeba started invading. Oh my god, that's terrible. It might be even... Q172. That was what I was afraid of. Yeah, you see they... taking Virak and immediately started. Okay, there's a trick I know which might help, but yeah, I've switched my prioritization from happiness to I wonder if I can defeat it. Because this colony ship may ruin my plan. If he will... No... Okay, what can I do? Okay, start building this auto labs to where I can. It requires quite a bit of production. Okay, with just team system, I will try to make a trick where minus 25 hit points. Oh, it's he moved away. That's nice of him. Maybe they started a war between each other, and that's a perfect situation for me. Yeah, that's probably the case. Seven pawns turns to outpost, 11 turns to outpost. Actually, my dream right now is to start having peace with everybody, so they will not attack me. But they seem not to want to do this, because for some reason you cannot negotiate with people right away. You need to wait lots of turn, like really lots of turn, before. Okay, we'll start this and this. Before you can even, make peace with them. Let's see. Minus 8 is okay. And it's especially hard on fast game settings, because they do not recalculate it. So if okay, I will for a while I will make them make money. For a game where the number of turns is, 200, wait for 20 turns before you can even make sure they will not attack you, it's too many. I think it's a miscalculation on the developer's part. Okay, this planet is... Oh, we should immediately colonize ocean. And I think they wanted to go at us. it's not good. Okay, what next? I think we will go for a happiness. Automatons, sue for peace. Station is far from being perfect because they breached our blockade. And they are far from our production center. So it's a negative situation. I think that's mean we will soon start war with the Amoeba faction, which is never good in this thanks God we managed to do this in time. Because at this point I am not worried about... I don't want to worry about wars, I want to worry about... about production. Because pretty soon we will start having morale problems. Other stuff and being distracted on war, especially given amount of bonuses that AI have in ground combat, in space combat. It's never good. So they have oh my god. Actually, I didn't mean to do this, so let's skip it. Okay, so we successfully retreated. And I think it's time for us to start building our fleet. Because the situation is not good. Not good at all. Okay, you will then build a colony ship to get this planet. They've taken two of our planets and want to have another one. You will build a colony ship. And you're good for now. Actually, at this point, a piece with amoeba wouldn't hurt. It's not like they did that bad, because I have already taken what I wanted the most. The best situation would be if they would continue attack me. Colonized lava, okay. In turns, no, that's not good. Okay, let's see if we can take something from amoeba faction. And I think we will take this tundra. Make some improvements. Iris, another one. Still don't want to have peace. Okay, they would love to have peace, but okay, I think I will leave this for later, this technology. I will take a diplomatic, and I will take, let's see, I will take a missile. Because my basic My basic weapon is not that great. Cannot colonize deserts yet. I will go for Arctic first. Okay, let's leave it this way. Actually, amoeba are pretty annoying. And I think I will... Yeah. Let's see what they have. They have kinetic weapon with flag cannons, flag beam. No, it's actually a pretty strong force, as I see it. I don't want to go at war with them yet, of course. And as you see, my morale problems are starting to develop. A bunch of my planets have a zero morale. They have strikes. Most of them are my home colonies. As you might see, yeah, you see, more than a half. So war with anyone is in my plan. So the best we can get from them is 5 gold for... okay. By the way... Can we... I think it would be a good thing to have open borders with automatons. Because this guys. We want them as our friends. Because they can hit amoeba. And as you've guessed, we do not like amoeba at all. They are our severe enemies that we would like to destroy as quick as possible. So another couple of technologies in the queue. Okay. No, we need this one technology. That will remove some of our expansion disapproval from our systems. Because, as I said, we've developed too fast, too quick. And it's not always good. Can't. And the bad thing that oh, another one. So we have peace almost with everyone, and no, I keep building this useless defenders. Don't even know why. Yeah, this one much more expensive. Okay, let's see if we can retrofit. This is there is an option to upgrade your ships. It's you do not spend production on it, you spend money on it. Is it old one? Yes. Just retreat. So we try to save situation by building these infinite supermarkets. We'll see where we'll go with that. So finally we've removed the siege from one of our systems. So we can continue the good old development. And our the level. Let's see. Okay, this one is a nice planet. This one would be nice too. And yeah, that's it for now. Actually, I see that generally speaking, amoeba do not have that big of a fleet. Okay, I don't know why they transfer warp length. Okay, don't know why they do not want to offer peace or accept peace. There isn't even an option to do that. Maybe they're just assholes. There is always such a possibility. But then it's their right to do that. Let's try to get rid of this nasty. Each. Okay, well, my missiles, you see, in this game, flak cannons are extremely, yeah, you see, extremely effective. Okay, invasions. Okay, we've managed to trade something from from Sheridan's. I don't know why they have such demand in my technologies, in my maybe they quite do not have a luck. With what they got from the beginning. So we've helped them a little bit. Okay, this amoeba begin to be such a quite a problem. But I don't think I'm ready to go full scale war on them. So I think I will let them take a couple of my not important star systems before I will retaliate. One more thing I would like is to... Yes, to... be able to have an alliance. I would definitely go for alliance with these guys, automatons. But it might take a while before we get there. Okay, do I need this? Maybe. Okay, see that my ships are quite have some effects on my enemy. So I think I will. Yeah, I will go for trying to defend myself, but that would be in the next video. So, guys, thank you for watching, and comrades, you are dismissed.